I first read My Side of the Mountain when I was 9 years old. My mom went to a book fair and she got it. And I was like, this is the dumbest looking book ever. But I read it and I was like, that was mind blown. Changing my life forever. My name is Zane Muhlestein. I'm a falconer in Utah. Started falconry at the age of 13, so pretty young. I first started out with American Kestrel and have almost only flown them since then. Falconry is the sport of hunting with a trained bird of prey. So whether that is wild caught, captive bred, it's all falconry, as long as you are going out doing what the bird would naturally do in the wild, because they're hunting animals. They're not pets at all. You're just going out and participating in the hunt. You are a hunting partner for them. Here on Falconry Told, we've broken down the process into 5 steps. Step number 1, take the test. Most areas, most states require you to pass with at least 80%. Second step is finding a sponsor and getting that sponsor to agree to sponsor you for the 2 years that you would be an apprentice. Step number 3, gather your equipment and get your facilities put together. Step number 4, you have to get everything inspected. You have to get your sponsor's letter sent into the state. And then step number 5 is you get your license and you go out and you be a falconer. So step number 1 is taking your test. Every state requires you to take the test. Most states require that you pass with at least 80%. The reason you take the test very first is to show how serious you are about the sport. This is going to ensure that you are going to find the best sponsor. Most sponsors won't even take you on unless you pass the test first. So how do you go and take your test? That's usually the first question people ask. How you go and take your test is you have to contact your local Division of Wildlife or Department of Natural Resources. The administrator will set a date and a time for you to come in and take your test. Usually it takes about 2 hours depending on how long the test is. Most of the tests are about 120 questions long. You're not just gonna go and take your test randomly. You are going to want to study and learn first. So the things you usually need to know are basic husbandry, raptor identification, diseases, your local laws, sometimes the federal laws as well. How you can learn about all these things are books. The main book that I would use is the California Hawking Club Apprentice Study Guide. That's what I used. I passed my first time. Another one is online. You can go to The Modern Apprentice, Falconry Told, and there are a lot of mock tests that you can take online as well. Step number 2 is finding a sponsor. This can be the toughest step because a sponsor is taking their own time, their own money, their own energy, and their own efforts. They are helping you to become the best falconer you can be. The best way to meet your sponsor is to go to meets. You should contact your state club and see if they have a list of sponsors. Usually they do. Usually they have a list of people who are willing to sponsor. And then you want to meet each of those people and you want to demonstrate how knowledgeable you are. You want to be extremely polite. You don't want to talk about stuff that you don't know about. If you don't know something, ask. Your sponsor has to let the state know that they are going to sponsor you. Usually they will write a letter or fill out a form, and then they will give it to the state. Step number 3 is accumulating your equipment and building your facilities. This is step number 3 after you find your sponsor, because everybody has their own specifications for their equipment and for their means. Don't try to do this before your sponsor can help you, because not everything is going to be correct. Your sponsor knows what they want and they have reasons why they want it the way they want it. You'll have your own opinion eventually, but follow your sponsor's advice first. There are state and federal laws concerning your facilities and your equipment. Every state has its own different take on what facilities should be like. Follow what your sponsor says. The equipment you'll need for your inspection, there might be more than this, but you will need anklets, Jess's a swivel, a leash, your perch, your bath pin, your glove, your scale, and your Mews. You're gonna want to get your equipment and your Mews built for the bird that you want to get. Follow exactly what your sponsor says. They will know what bird is best for you, for your area. Listen to what they say. Step number four is getting your sponsor's letter sent in and your equipment and Mews inspected by the state. You'll want to contact your local Division of Wildlife or Department of Natural Resources, or you can have your sponsor get you that contact information. Just like your test, you're going to have a specific date and time set to have your equipment and Mews inspected. Once you have everything inspected and it passes, then they'll get you your paperwork, you'll fill it out, you'll send it in, and move on to step five. Step number five, getting your license and being a falconer. Usually your state wildlife division will be very busy, so it may take a little while for you to get your license, but after a little bit, they'll send you your apprentice license. You'll go out with your sponsor, you'll trap a bird in season, and then you will be an apprentice for 2 years. You'll either have one or two birds throughout those 2 years, whatever your sponsor decides they want you to have. After you're done with your apprentice license, you will become a general, which gives you more opportunities and more responsibilities. You'll be a general for 5 years, and then you will be eligible to be a master falconer. In conclusion, this isn't always how it works out. The timing is different for everybody. Every sponsor is different. They may have different requirements for you. They may have a specific set of rules that you have to follow. But in general, this is how it's going to go. Getting into falconry is hard. It's a long process. It's going to be difficult to get into, but it doesn't have to be confusing. If you decide this is for you, then Falconry Told wishes you the best of luck. If you don't, we hope you continue to watch our videos and learn about what falconry really is. For additional information, you can contact your state club, and they will usually give you an information packet with steps on how to be a falconer in your state. We also will help you out with your journey, and we wish you the best of luck.